somehow when everybody was away, you know, everybody was busy. And actually they succeeded for passing exams for some time, and it was until the following week that we started the California Scholars, you know, to know about it. And it's hard for me, I'll explain it more details, but it's based on a letter from Mark Gilbert, who is the president of the University of California, in which he voices concern over the well-being of Jewish students because the climate of UC campuses is very hostile to them. It was a very dangerous letter because in it he described activities that were against Israeli policies, or, you know, the kind of things you just mentioned, all of you, you know, the activities SJP would do or any other organization would do as hate speech. And this is a very, very dangerous accusation. And in it he also compared these types of activities to anti-Semitic activities like the writing or painting swastikas on the doors of Jewish students, which definitely anti-Semitic, okay, we don't, I think everybody would agree on that. However, to compare it and almost equate it with the kind of activities that SJP or other student organizations in support of the Palestinians would do is a very, very dangerous thing. The problem is that he formed committees, two committees, to investigate the climate on UC campuses, one for Jewish students, one for Muslim and Arab students, and I will explain those in more details. Based on the reports that came out, especially the report on student, I mean the report on Muslim and Arab students was totally ignored. All the focus was on the report on Jewish students, which had many problems I will discuss later. And the California legislature just adopted HR 35, which has many problems, but one of them is they actually equate anti-Semitism with any anti-Israel discourse or rhetoric. And this is a very, very dangerous thing. Now, it's not a law, by the way. You have to know this, you have to know your rights. So it's not a law and it's not abiding. And actually, the University of California rejected the resolution based on one sentence which actually says that any organization or entity like, you know, faculty members can't use the resources of either California State University or the California State University or the University of California system to engage in such activities. So actually the University of California, though it was engaged, the administration was engaged with the people who proposed the resolution, they ended up rejecting it because it's not constitutional. They can't really conclude that. They worked with lawyers and they were informed that, you know, you have to be careful about what you say here, and now it's not legally binding. However, the danger is that it would encourage administrators both at the UC system and the Cal State system to take actions against faculty, students, students, organizations, and staff for engaging in such dialogue, in such discourse or activities, or even just voicing opinions.